Turkey sector, which was once a sunrise sector, now stuck in a spate of litigation, the telecom sector. Now, you suggested a way out to the Minister of Telecommunications. You actually said reduce the base price even more dramatically for the third round of auctions and perhaps even allow spectrum trading. It will create a secondary market for spectrum. Is that the way forward, Dr. Ahluwalia?
Well, I mean, this is a matter that will go before the GOM.
That's on the agenda now?
I'm expressing my view. I don't think there can be any doubt that the reserve price would have to be lowered, because we tried with a reserve price which we lowered, but we obviously didn't lower it enough and there were no takers. So, I mean, what are the choices?
So how much lower should it be?
Well, my point was, in order to avoid making arbitrary reductions where the last statutorily valid advice is from the TRAI report of a few years ago, which many people say was obviously over-influenced by market conditions then. And then headlines say that, you know, once again you're lowering it further. I suggested that we refer the matter to TRAI. Because, you know, it's an independent, a statutory independent body. And in my view, we should certainly go ahead and auction. We should not fail to do that. Because, frankly, it's a resource, it's a national resource, it should be used and made available, okay? The way to get the auction going is known, because the auction method is now well tried. If we start doing, preparing for that auction, it'll take a certain amount of time. You have to choose the auctioneer, et cetera, et cetera. The reserve price only has to be declared much closer to the actual auction.
And you want TRAI?
And I'm saying let TRAI do it, because, you know, we're not bound by TRAI's advice. But the only way we can look at these things is if TRAI gives a fresh recommendation. Sure. That will also enable TRAI to take a view on how much market conditions have changed.
What about spectrum trading? Is that also?
I think that's a no-brainer in my view.
But
I
mean, is that going to TRAI for reference, or is that going up to the GM?
I can't object if the DOT wants to make a reference. They can make a reference. In my view, I can see no logical reason for not allowing spectrum trading. In the old days, when you were giving away spectrum at a fixed price, you could argue that, you know, a trader would simply rake in an unfair benefit. If you're auctioning it and the person knows that it's tradable, you will get a fair price taking into account the value of the auction.
So you're
this would be a very big change in policy, because at the moment we haven't allowed it. And I hope that they will, well, they'll certainly look at it, and let's see what happens.
Right. Coming back to the economy, Dr. Ahluwalia, we know that the pain point really is the CAD, and everybody's talking about it, whether it's the finance minister or the foreign investing voices. 6.7% for the last quarter is a shocker. And how do we address this? There is an issue with the rupee. There are some voices which say now the rupee will be pressurized, perhaps at 55 to 60 levels. Is that the view we share with them? And in the upcoming foreign trade policy, what is it that the government can do to actually ensure that that gap is bridged somewhat?
Well, you know, first of all, I agree with you that the current account deficit, what you call the CAD, is a problem area at the moment. I think the 6.7% of GDP is a quarterly figure, and those figures tend to be, they can be volatile. I would say that if you look at the year as a whole, maybe 5% or a little more than 5% is what it will end up being for the year as a whole. That's still too high. It's twice what I would call a comfort level. So it's very clear that we have to bring the current account deficit down. The government strategy on that is that we are bringing about a fiscal contraction. It's a gradual one. I mean, it'll take 4 years to be reduced by 2 percentage points of GDP. But that'll certainly get reflected in the current account deficit. A critical element of this strategy is that in the meantime, the current account deficit must be financed. Now, I feel that if India can be managed in such a way that the public recognizes that we are on a transition path as far as fiscal consolidation is concerned, not that we've reached a comfortable level, but we're really on a consolidation path, and if the supply bottlenecks that are holding up investment are taken care of, so the economy looks as if it's getting back to, you know, 6.5, maybe next year over 7, and then 8% growth, we should be able to attract FDI, FII, other external flows, for another 2 years in order to be able to maintain this deficit.
As of now, I think we are financing it more through portfolio flows, which are volatile, as you would know. But one option that has been floated by the finance ministry is sovereign bonds. And I think the RBI has shot it down because it perhaps might impact yield. The tenure could be a little more volatile if you go for sovereign bonds. Do you subscribe to that view?
But I have no idea whether the finance ministry has actually made such a proposal. You know, at the official level, many things are being are always discussed. You know, all that sovereign bonds does is it brings in foreign exchange, commercially borrowed foreign exchange at a somewhat lower level than the money would come if you let the corporate sector borrow. So I think that India in the long term ought to be getting into sovereign borrowing simply in order to set a benchmark. I mean, that's the idea. Ideally, though, I mean, we've always felt that, you know, we ought to do it when you don't need to do it.
Right.
You know, after all, if you want to set a benchmark, and nothing's stopping you from doing some borrowing and just stick the money in the reserves. So I would not say that at this point, this is necessarily the point where you do it. But, you know, on the other hand, we do a lot of sub-sovereign borrowing anyway. And the difference between sub-sovereign and sovereign is only a little bit of interest rate spread. I think the finance ministry can decide whether they really want to do it or not want to do it.